Hi guys, it's Denma, and welcome to The Wolf's Den. And today is part 2 of the Animal Hospital Paranormal Series. If you didn't see part 1 where I explained more about the building and what happened in the building, please watch part 1 first. It's really quick. It's down below. And then come back to this video. This one's going to be kind of short because these are other people's experiences and not my own, so I can't really elaborate too much on the details because, like I said, they're not my own experiences. So, as I said in the last video, Ray the NPC, aka my husband, was working there for a brief time, and he had his name called, but his name is Ray Common, but still, when you don't have AC or air on, no radios on, no TVs on, where can the source of the sound come from? We were empty, completely empty in the large runs, but we still had to rinse them down just to get pet fur, dander, or whatever out of the runs. And he had all the doors open, and all of a sudden they all slammed shut, and the door to the outside was shut, and the two doors leading into the large runs, which were by the surgical suite and the kennel door, they both were shut, so there was no airflow. So there was no way wind could have done that. And these doors are heavy gate type doors. They probably weigh a good 15 to 20 pounds by themselves. So whatever had that much energy to swing 20 doors of that weight shut at the same time is powerful. Nothing ever happened that was like harmful. It was just mischievous type stuff. Nothing ever hurt us or hurt any of the co-workers. So I'm going to tell a couple of their stories. We had a receptionist. I'll just go with her first initial, N. N had been working there for 10 to 20 years because this was a very old facility, and she'd been working there since like the 80s. And I started working there in 2002, so she was still there. And she was there on several occasions, and we hear her name called. And her name is, it's a common name, but it's not one that you hear every day. So that was kind of weird, considering me and Lazy PC had our names called. A couple of the other employees, older ones, had that experience as well. An office manager and the other receptionist had that experience. A lot of the newer employees never had any experiences, but there was a lot of turnaround, because people would think that the kennel or taking would be an easy job, and it is not. Because you get attached to these animals, something bad happens to them, and it's like you lose your own pets, your own kids. It just hurts so bad. The other receptionist, will say her name or her letter VW. W was coming to work one day. She drove a minivan, and the office manager, will say, was P. And P was just coming into the building, so she had run to the alarm, shut the alarm off, and was holding the door open for W. And she looked, and it was like, you know, peeping around, looking, and as W was walking, P is asking W, who is that in the van with you? And W turned and looked at the man and shook her head. She said, nobody was with me, but there was clearly another person, I think it was a woman, P had seen, and she told this to W. So they had kept that to themselves until N had the same experience. They both drove minivans. So funny. They were both the same color, the same style van. And N had pulled up, and P was waiting for her. Somebody had already gotten there. Another kennel worker had gotten there early and already clicked their alarm off. And P was waiting for N to come in, and she asked her, who was that in the van with you? Is that one of your daughters? Because she has three daughters. And one was like in driver's ed, so she thought that the daughter was going to drive the van back home or wherever. And she's like, nobody was with me. So that was kind of weird. And they had both receptionist and the one office manager had the same exact experience. And the only one that knew both stories was the office manager, and she didn't tell them until later when we were talking about like the experiences that I had. I know the groomer that when I first got there, she was there. She had been there a while, but she left about 3 or 4 months after I got there. She retired, but she had heard her name called several times. The other kennel worker that was with me, the main one that stayed, because we had so many like teenagers coming in to do kennel work during the summer, and they just couldn't handle it and kept calling it out, and one of us would have to come. And so we'll call her G. I know G had heard her name, and her name is not very common, and it's very hard not to get it right, but it's not a common name. So she had heard that, and she had seen quote unquote ghost animals. She had seen cats running around loose in the veterinary office when there were no cats mourning, or there was like one or two, but they were all locked away, because with cats, we had a cat room that had its own door that we could shut. So we would open one cage, or if the cat got along with other cats, then we'd open up multiple cages, let the cats run around, get some fresh air, get their legs, stretch their little paws, and we would, after we were done with the dogs, we'd come put them back up, give them fresh food, litter, all that good stuff, and the cats were gone. We did have a house cat, but she was put in a cage because they didn't want her setting off the alarm after we left. So she was put in a cage in the cat room. It wasn't her, it was another cat, like a solid gray cat she kept seeing. So that's those stories, and those are all that I know of that they told me. They said, Anne had said she could write a book about all the experiences that she had had during her time there. I wish I would have kept a journal of all the interesting things that had happened, not just the paranormal things, just with like clients and stuff, because it would have been an interesting read. But that is the end of the ghost stories. I don't know what happened anytime after that, but if I have any more paranormal experiences, I will make sure to document them and tell you. Have you had any paranormal experiences? Please put them in the comments below. I would love to hear them or read them. And if you have a video you would like me to react to, or a song, or whatnot, let me know in the comments below as well. If I pick yours, I'll definitely give you a shout out. And like, subscribe, join the pack. We would love to have you here. And until next time, stay spooky. Bye guys. It's been a couple of days since I recorded the Animal Hospital video, and I was browsing through Facebook, and of course this person, like, it's a lot of older people posting about God and heaven and all that, and the question was, do you believe that people who have passed on still contact you? And I'm like, yes, and pets too. It's still a touchy subject. Last month we lost Ketgar, which was the one I found barely a year ago. I just got his rabies renewal in the mail about a week before, and we don't know what happened. We just woke up and we were gone. And usually it's like a sign of underlying heart conditions, be it kitty heartworms or a heart condition, because that they don't show any signs. So I looked him over and he looked like he was asleep, and he was gone, and it hurt so bad. But then a few days ago, I was sitting here in my parents' bed like I am, laying down, and I was going back to sleep, and I have Grady in here with me, because she's pretty well behaved. I felt something jump on the bed and curl up behind me, because sometimes she'll do that. And I even felt like the warmth from my body curl up behind me. I was like, oh, that feels good on my back, because it was hurting. So I reached over to feel and pet her. There was absolutely nothing there. And I'm like, it must have been Ketgar, because he was very gentle whenever he jumped on you or on things, and very delicate, and he liked to curl up right in the nook of my back, or if I was on my side, because I sleep like in like a Z formation, he would curl up in the nook of my knees. But yeah, I just wanted to add that to this one. I know it's my experience and it's not like the animal hospital experience, but it's animal related.